Good morning. My name is Paola Grenni. I'm a senior researcher at the National Research Council of Italy Water Research Institute. My presentation is Green Economy and Wastes. How is it possible to combine them? One health concept is based on the fact that a single health for people, animals, and environment are combined together. In particular, there is a global view of one health because it is an approach to design and implementing programs, policies, and legislation, a research in which multiple sectors work together and to achieve better public health outcomes. In particular, as you can see in this figure, human health, environmental health, and human health are very strictly connected. Since several years, there are a day dedicated to One Health, and it is November the 3rd. In this concept, animals, plants, and humans share the same ecosystems, which requires multiple sectors to work together for ensuring the environmental health. In this framework, the role of waste is very important because the improper waste management, such as handling and disposal of waste, can affect the public health and the environment. In this slide, you can see the different sustainable development goals that are connected to solid waste management. The 17 United Nations Sustainable Development Goals that were in the framework of the for a sustainable environment were connected to three different sustainability domains: ecology, economy, and society. And as you can see, several of these goals are connected to waste management. In particular, the number one, no poverty; the number two, zero hunger; three, good health and well-being; quality education; gender equality; affordable and clean energy; clean water and sanitization; decent work and an economic growth; industry, innovation, and infrastructure; reduced inequalities; sustainable cities and communities; climate action; life below water; life on land; responsible consumption and production; and peace and justice, strong institutions, and partnership for the cause. So all these goals are connected to chemicals and waste management. So it is very important to manage the waste in order to have a good life. In this slide, you can see the waste hierarchy, the community's approach to waste management policy is based on the guiding principle of the waste hierarchy, which gives preference first to waste prevention, then to waste recovery, which include reuse, recycling, and energy recovery, with preference being given to material recovery, and lastly, to waste disposal, which includes incinerator without energy recovery and landfill. So it is a preference to have a prevention or the reuse of the wastes. Landfill is the last favored option at the bottom of the waste hierarchy, below waste prevention, reuse, recycling and incineration. The European Circular Economy Package was promoted in 18 by Europe. It includes four directives that were adopted. The first one was the directive for the end-of-life vehicles, batteries and accumulators. The second one was for the landfill of waste. Another one was for the waste and waste management, and the third was for packaging and packaging waste. The Circular Economy Package sets recycling goals for both municipal and packaging waste. In particular, by 2025, 50% of the municipal waste has to be recycled, and in the following years, 2030 and 2035, a large amount of municipal waste has to be recycled. In March 2020, new European Circular Economy Action Plan was performed. It is one of the main building blocks of the European Green Deal. It includes the entire life cycle of product, with the aim to make our economy fit for a green future, strengthening our competitiveness, protecting the environment. The new plan focuses on the design and production for a circular economy with the aim to ensure that the resources used are kept in the European economy for as long as possible. It proposes measures to design waste out of the economy by transforming it into high-quality secondary resources that are fed back into the production process. To that end, the Commission will explore setting an European-wide harmonized model for the separate collection on the waste and labeling. But what is the importance of waste classification? In the framework of the new European Circular Economy Action Plan and the 7 Environment Action Program, waste management should involve energy recovery and waste recycling, making it into secondary raw materials. In particular, the Waste Framework Directive is the European Directive number 98 of 2008. And this directive is amended by a decision and two directives. The first one, the list of waste, are listed in the decision. The directive 1127 is the list of recovery operations, and the Directive 851 entered in force in Italy with the decree last year. In particular, for the Waste Framework Directive, the Annex 3 reported the list's properties of waste, which render it hazard. In particular, there are a list of hazard properties for different wastes, and we will focus on hazard property HP14, that is ecotoxic. The European Commission publishes 3 years ago a technical guidance on hazard waste classification, and this guide aims to provide clarification and guidance on the correct interpretation and application of relevant European legislation regarding the classification of waste, assessing if the waste has hazardous properties, and ultimately classifying the waste as hazardous or not hazardous. The notice is structured in the 3 chapter and 4 annexes. a background to ways classification instruction on how to read the guidance, relevant parts of European ways classification, and briefly presented and their relevance for the definition and classification of hazard waste, and then general steps for waste classification, highlighting the basic concepts but without entering into detailed discussions. There are a list of several annexes, as I told before. The Annex 1 is list of waste, Annex 2 different sources of information on hazardous substances and their classification, and the Annex 3 the principles for the assessment of the individual hazardous for the properties hazard properties 1 to hazard properties 15. The Annex 4 there are a basic concept for available standards and methods regarding waste sampling and chemical analysis for the classification system. Now we will focus on municipal solid waste. They are produced during the incineration of solid waste. In Europe, about 500 kilograms per year inhabitant of municipal solid waste are produced. The most abundant solid waste are, in consequence, the municipal ones. Municipal solid waste incinerators produce this waste in bottom ash and fly ash. Bottom ash and fly ash are classified as mirror entry material under the the Waste Framework Directive in the European List of Waste, with specific entry codes, hazardous and not hazardous, as you can see in this slide. So, is it possible to classify bottom ash and fly ash for the classification of ecotoxic? Because the directive that refers to waste classification report not so many details for the classification for this kind of solid waste. Bottom ash and fly ash are classified as mirror entries due to their content in soluble salts, potentially toxic metals, trace organic pollutants, and high pH in contact with water. Wastes in the category mirror entry can be either hazardous or not hazardous, depending on the type and concentration of pollutants they contain. Further evaluation is possible to classify them as hazardous or not hazardous if we perform different ecotoxicological tests. Since high cost may be involved for landfill, for example 150 to 500 euros per ton are required for the landfill, the recovery recycling option may become an alternative. HP14 ecotoxic, present or may present immediate or delayed risks for one or more sector for the environment. This is the classification for waste that is ecotoxic. The HP14 property is assessed from the combination of two approaches. Summation method, in which the summation of classified compounds, for example, metals and so on, in the waste, is carried out according to the regulation on classification, labeling and packaging, that is another regulation at the European level for the classification of the substances and mixtures. Then some biotest, in particular ecotoxicological test, can be performed, and the results are useful for the classification of the waste. HP14 classification is based, as I told you, on chemical analysis of waste. But because the chemical composition is not fully known, bottom ash and fly ash have to be classified performing a ecotoxicological test. For the sample preparation, as they are difficult samples to test, for the complex composition and low water solubility, several OECD guidance are used. For example, OECD number 29, that is a guidance document on the transformation of the solution of metals and metal compounds in aqueous media. Another guidelines, OECD number 23, is the guidance document on the aquatic toxicity testing of difficult substances and mixture. These guidance are useful for the sample preparation. The ecotoxicological test that can be applied and used can be different, of course, but which is the appropriate ecotoxicological test battery to be applied? Which kind of organism can be used? How to treat waste containing difficult substances and mixture, e.g. sieving, for example? How to make extract from the waste on which perform bioassays? In particular, algal growth inhibition test, crustacea acute toxicity test, and fish acute toxicity test are the main tests that are used. In this slide, you can see the other property 14 for the ecotoxic evaluation, in particular for the summation methods. In this method, waste which fulfill any of the following conditions shall be classified as hazardous by HP14. Waste which contains a substance classified as ozone depleting assigned the other statement called H420 in accordance with the regulation of 2008, and the concentration of such a substance equals or exceed the concentration limit of 0.1. Waste which contains one or more substances classified as aquatic acute 1 in accordance with the same regulation, and the sum of the concentration of those substances is equal or more than 25%. A cutoff value is 0.1%. Waste which contains one or more substances classified as aquatic chronic 1 or 2 or 3, for the same regulation, and the sum of the concentration of all substances classified as aquatic chronic 1 multiplied by 100 added to the sum of the concentration of all substances classified as aquatic chronic 2 multiplied by 10 and added to the sum of the concentration of all substances classified as aquatic chronic 3. The cutoff values, as you can see, is 0.1 for H410, 1% for H411 or H412. The last one for the summation method is for the waste which contain one or more substances classified as aquatic chronic 1, 2, 3, or 4. As you can see, there are the same summation method, and this sum has to be more than 25%. In this case, the waste is classified as ecotoxic. Also, in this case, there is a cutoff values different depends on the chronic code. So HP14, as I told you, is the ecotoxic evaluation for different aquatic acute or chronic evaluation, and in this table there is a summation of the different methods depending on the fact that there is one or more contaminants that are already classified for these codes. For example, one metal can be with aquatic acute one evaluation, and so in this case all the substances has to be summarized, and these values, if it is more than 25%, the waste is classified as ecotoxic. Then you can see the different codes, H400 and H410, and so on. There is the different categories for the hazardous. Also, in the case of bottom ash and fly ash, that are the ashes that are after the incineration of waste, can be analyzed for the chemical compounds. And the main issues are the metals. In fact, during the production process, the information of the waste and the raw material used are not well known in different parts. So the selection of relevant or reasonably predictable substances to analyze in the waste are basically metals, and in particular cadmium, zinc, etc. With classification, so will be based on the substances, but normally the elements are analyzed, not the substances. So the exact speciation of the substances in the waste material from the thermal processes is not known. The metals are often assumed as oxide, zinc oxide, and so on. And this choice is precautionary because they are the most worst toxic compound compared to the potential present, the so-called worst case. Metal, in particular, are present in massive form or in powder. This is not well known, and for this reason, it is very hard to classify bottom ash and fly. Speciation choice influences the waste classification based on the summation method. As you can see in this table, zinc or zinc oxide has the same toxicity, but for example, other compound can have different classification. Oxide have the hazardous statement codes H400 and H410. The multiplier factor M is equal to 100. So a low limit value originates from the statement code attribution, and in particular, the waste is very frequently classified as ecotoxic if it is based only in on the element analysis. The toxicological test for waste can be an alternative, in particular for this kind of waste, bottom ash and fly ash. There is only a problem, because if waste contain metals, the metals are not soluble in water. For ecotoxicological test, they can have to do elution of the waste, but in the eluates, the metals, because they are not soluble, are not contained. So inorganic substances such as metals with low solubility need to be analyzed by the transformation dissolution test, a specific OECD test. Solid waste and weights, water accommodated fraction, are produced through a leaching test with loading rates, different amount of waste, and tested with a biotest battery, so a different test for the aquatic organism, for example with the bacteria or with algae or with crustacean. Concentration limits indicate, in terms of AC50 or NOEC, and are expressed in terms of loading rate. Prepare a water fraction in accordance with the OECD 23 and OECD 29 with a loading rate 100 mg per liter. The responsible of the different test, the toxicological test, for example, the fresh algae, can have an effect. If yes, the waste can be classified as hazardous for ecotoxic value. If not, can be applied, for example, for the crustacean. But why we apply firstly freshwater algae? Because this organism is more sensible to the different contaminants. Then we can apply the crustacean OECD test. If there are an effect, the waste can be classified as hazardous. If not, another test with the fish can be applied. If there is an effect, it can be classified as an hazardous waste. But if not, we can prepare the water fraction with a loading rate of 1 mg per liter. And then we can apply the fresh algae test, the Daphnia magnia, so the crustacean test, and then the fish test, in order to have the classification of the waste as hazardous or not. This CLP-based approach, no chronic test and terrestrial organism test are considered. In fact, we applied only alga, crustacean, and fish tests. Since metals have a very low solubility, direct tests on solid waste with terrestrial organisms could be useful. Waste-based approach is a proposal. Classification of waste for ecotoxic classification with aquatic and terrestrial tests could be found. Concentration limits based on the concentrations producing the highest ecotoxical effect in a non-hazardous waste is the possible way. Some concluding remarks. Specific recommendation methodologies to be applied for the classification for ecotoxic terms of waste for achieving an European harmonization that standardization of testing methods for waste classification are needed to optimize waste classification, favoring its reuse. In any case, we propose a flow method. Different waste classification has also consequences on the European Agreement concerning the international carriage of dangerous goods by road. In fact, if the waste is classified differently, they can be transported or not. Appropriate biases and suitable concentration limit determinants lead to municipal waste incineration ashes containing metals classification as a secondary raw material, so it can be reused in line with the new European Circular Economy Action Plan.